I'm gonna see a really, really big one. Twice the size. Bubbles have got lots of interesting properties and it can be fun to investigate these with your children. You can buy bubble mixture from the shops, but it's easy enough to make at home. All you need is a good quality washing up liquid, add that to some water, and hey presto, you get some nice bubbles. In order to make it even better, all you need to do is add some glycerin to it, and you can get the glycerin from your local chemists. You could have one of these bubble wands lying around the house, but the great thing about bubbles though is that you can make them with almost anything. So for example, I've used a simple cookie cutter that I find in my kitchen, or a pipe cleaner, which has been bent into shape. Experimenting with different ways to make bubbles is a great way to get children thinking scientifically as they play.
Can you tell me what do you think is going to happen if you blow really, really hard?
It'll make a bigger bubble.
Do you think it's going to make a bigger bubble?
Yeah.
Okay, should we try? What do you think is going to happen if you use a fatter straw or a bigger straw?
Same thing.
Do you think the same thing's going to happen? Okay, should we have a go? What do you think? Do you think that using a different straw made a difference to the bubbles?
Yes.
Yeah? Right, so we're going to have a go at trying to make one with this pipe cleaner. Alright, you can make something similar. Very good. I did it. Wow, wow. Keep going. Amazing, well done. What do you think is going to happen if I use a different shape? So for example, this one. What type of bubble do you think I'm going to get from that?
Star.
You think I'm going to get a star one? Should we have a go?
Yeah.
Yeah? Look at the bubble. What does it look like?
Circle.
And what do you think is going to happen with the hand shape?
It will go into a circle.
It will go into a circle. Should we have a go?
Yeah.
Yeah? When you blow up a balloon, you have to blow hard. The air inside the balloon has to press outwards and stretches the rubber of the balloon. When you tie up the balloon, the air inside it carries on pressing outwards and the rubber presses inwards. These forces balance each other and give the balloon its shape. A similar thing happens when you blow a soap bubble, but instead of rubber, it is a thin skin of soap solution that contains the air. Your bubble may start off in a funny shape, but the soap film is always pulling inwards and the air is pushing outwards. The bubble ends up shaped like a sphere because then the outward force of the air exactly balances the inward force of the soap film in all directions. Right, shall we try and make an even bigger bubble?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, so I'm gonna show you a really, really big bubble, okay? You excited?
Wow.
To make really big bubbles, you can just use a cake tin or even a coat hanger. But what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you how to make a big bubble wand using some string, two wooden spoons and a weight, which is going to be a key. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to take your string and you need to loop it through and tie it around one of your wooden sticks. The next thing you need to do is you need to take your key, which is going to act as your weight, and you are going to pass that through the string again. So it's roughly about a third down your string. What you are really aiming for is you are trying to form a bubble wand which is in a triangular shape. So this actually forms the first side of my triangle. So the next thing you need to do is then take your string and then take your second wooden stick or your spoon and again pass that through.
and that should be about 2/3 of your string, and then make another knot. So there you go, you've got the two sides of your triangle, and all you need now to do is complete the triangle. So you take the rest of the string, and it needs to be approximately the same size as the other two, so that's about right. And if I tie that around to finish off my bubble wand, so when I hold that up, what we end up with is a really, really nice triangular shape that I can now use to make some really, really big bubbles.
You put it in the bubble mix, take it away from it, and then open it, and then walk back slowly, and then when there's a bubble, you have to close it.
Wow! Oh, that's the wind.
Me
and Misha have flavored bubbles so many times before, but this time round, asking her questions, getting her to investigate the properties, getting her to look at them really, really closely, has meant that we've got so much more out of it. I do hope you do too.